Hey everyone, I just had a really interesting idea that I had recently. I mean, really, it's a combination of really two games, which are Pathologic and Nier. So in Pathologic, the whole premise of the polyhedron is that there's this thing that really shouldn't exist. Like the way it's structured, the way it's built, it doesn't confine or it doesn't follow the laws of physics at all. And it's this weird thing that exists, but it really shouldn't. And so it's almost part of this thing is, you know, I mean, the children go inside of it, and it's like the idea is that the children are actually using it to like travel through different places, and there's like just something like a bunch of mirrors inside of it. I mean, Pathologic in general, just a masterpiece of I don't know, schizo writing. I don't know how else to describe it, but I know the polyhedron is really fascinating because not only I think one of the landlords says that it essentially reflects human souls, and there's infinite possibilities within it, and it also reflects the soul of like the city, because the city or the town itself is, you know, like a body, and so this is kind of like the mind of the body. And so if you destroy it, it will lose the soul and the mind of the town, even though it's the thing that's actually killing it, as you find out in the original. But it just made me think, you know, it's something about the architecture, and the architect himself, you know, designed this thing, and it's almost like the spirit inhabits this thing. And so the identity of the town is ruled by the polyhedron, and it's almost like because of the way it's built, it shouldn't exist, and because it shouldn't exist, something has inhabited it that is not of this world. And so it made me think about, you know, we like to think that your body has no relation to your spirit, but what if it did? What if the shape and nature and construction of your body actually determined what kind of spirit could inhabit it? And that brings me to a more direct example, which is a Nier. Because the whole premise of Nier is that you have these replicants or these androids that are supposed to be these empty vessels that have no soul, essentially, and are sort of like automatons. And over time, over thousands of years, they actually develop these souls and personalities. And suddenly the gestalts and the souls that they extracted can no longer return to the original bodies. So it makes me think, you know, is there something about the structure of the automatons, that what they're made out of, that allows a soul to inhabit it? Or is it very much like a Shinto kind of thing where they just think souls can inhabit like anything? It doesn't matter if it's a rabbit or a tree or like even like a house or something, that spirits can inhabit anything. And so maybe because Nier himself is made out of, and again, that's not even his name, because, you know, they just call him Papa or Dad or whatever, or Big Guy. So he never really has an identity, because he's kind of like the player's identity or the soul of whatever has inhabited him. So, like, you know, it's a really interesting concept. But yeah, I always wondered if the function, the form, like related or dependent upon each other. It's a really interesting concept that I've seen both in Pathologic and Nier, and I know I'd like to see more of that kind of tackled, or just this kind of crazy writing in general. But anyway, just a little thought I had that I want to share with you guys. So yeah, bye.